Kuklo, who leads the Sharks with 6 points, gets it around the board. Pavelski trying to come out. He does and scores!
Carried the play into half zone. Been dominant. Look at the second and third effort. Take a look at this effort here by Joel Pavelski.
Behind the net now. Backhand in front. That just misses. Porter got it right through the slot. Porter again in the one-timer. Oh, what a miraculous save by Nabokov.
Good cycle by the Avs. Nice feed by Porter. Watch Nabokov read here. Look at how he turned his head, located that shooter. Watch him turn his head right here. And he comes across to the butterfly slide.
Wide pass. Murray shot off the backboards. It bounces to Klo. He tried to wrap around. A beauty here for Ryan Klo with a gaping net. Ahead for Duchesne. Cagliardi lined up on that one.
You had to know. The Sharks had their sights set on TJ Cagliardi. They've wanted to hit him all series long. He's been a burr in the saddle of a lot of players here. And you'll see Scott Nickel.
Pass to Svatos. Dancing away from Joe Thornton. Inside the Sharks zone. Cutting in front. He scores! What a play!
This is what he's brought to this lineup. He's been off injured. He's got great hands. Look at him absolutely beat three Sharks. Three Sharks to the net. Big Joe Thornton, Dan Boyle, and Douglas Murray. This is just a simple question of a guy that has a will.
Back to the line. Lyles, a one-timer and a quick glove save by Nabokov.
They move this puck around. Brandon Yip back on the point. He's a forward playing the point here. One-time setup. Opposite hand shot by John Michael Lyles.
Stastny nearly split the defense. In the corner, he comes off the boards. In front for Brandon Yip. He scores!
Great work through the neutral zone by the Avs. Established a cycle game, as head assistant coach Sylvain Lefebvre talked about. And look at this pass. It just gets under the blade of Huskins, who had that terrific block earlier in this period. And Brandon
Pavelski in. Backhand, missing the net, it bounces to Heatley, and he hits the goalpost! Danny Heatley with a great chance. Here's Boyle now, with urgency, he scores!
But look where Danny Heatley is stationed. Look at Heatley right in front of the net. We talked about it a few shifts back, he had to get in front of the net. Now watch Danny Boyle, walk the line, get away from the defender, and just watch the shot, and it may have actually been deflected. This shot was deflected.
That foot tried to get a piece of Pavelski. He's in with Setoguchi. Pavelski shoots and scores!
Does Joe Pavelski have a sense of timing? This is uncanny. This is just uncanny. He does this time and time and time again. And people are surprised. But he gets by Adam Foote along the wall. Adam Foote let Pavelski win that battle. Clearly. And he had that step. He fans on the first one. Gets an opportunity to second.
Three to Setoguchi. Setoguchi, the center, on goal, and in the net. That will ice it.
They still win this puck battle. Devin Setoguchi had a chance prior to this, and he won't miss twice.
The gaping net, plays it across for Doug Murray. Murray has a look and fires it in the net again, just to rub a little salt in the wounds.
We'll take a look at the battle one more time. Doug Murray, you know he's going for this one.
Nabokov, then he clears it himself with a stick. And Heatley will flip it high and just get it out as the horn sounds to end this hockey game. The San Jose Sharks coming from behind in this series win it 4-2 and move on to the second round. Craig Anderson did everything he could for the Avs. Nabokov, after a shaky start, was hard to beat in the last 4 games. As the coaching staff shake hands, Kevin, Joe Sacco, the rookie NHL coach, congratulating Tom McClellan, just his second year as an NHL head coach, as the Sharks move on tonight.
Well, as far as the Avalanche, they have to be happy with what they've accomplished. I know it's tough right now, particularly for the players in the locker room. Listen to the fans chanting, Andy, Andy, in appreciation of what Craig Anderson has done for this franchise this year. And for the Sharks, head coach Tom McClellan talked about the ability to overcome. And Mark, you touched on it, the fact that they were able to do so in coming from behind in this series.
The first 3 games, they had bad luck goals. None worse than the own goal that Danny Boyle put in overtime in game number 3. And, you know, you had to think that they were thinking, the only luck we have is bad. But they overcame that, and that's something that Todd McClellan was preaching from the beginning of this series. We're going to have to overcome. Dan Boyle did it, and the way he did it, I think, really bolstered this hockey team.
No question. For all our viewers and our listeners out there, you know, Dan Boyle is another example. A lot of youngsters out there that are playing that get frustrated at times. Dan Boyle is an undrafted player who's won a Stanley Cup and won Olympic gold for Canada. And you see how he was able to bounce back and help this Sharks team.
You know, he answered every question that dark night here in Denver. And then the next day, he also answered media questions. And it was a tough 48 hours for him. But now, he said, when I got that behind me, when we win this series, that's when I will truly be over that own goal. And they did it here tonight.